If astronomy research has taught us anything in the last couple decades, it's that all rocky planets are definitely not alike. For example, Earth has big puzzle pieces of crust that can run into each other to form mountain ranges or slide under each other to melt and recycle old rock. Meanwhile, parts of Venus's crust just seem to jostle around without sliding under each other at all. Scientists are always trying to understand these places, but they're also interested in understanding other worlds far from home, even hypothetical planets we haven't found yet. Like in a paper published online last month in the Journal of Geophysical Research Planets, a team outlined the possibility of eggshell planets, worlds with relatively featureless surfaces and thin, brittle crusts. And they may have even identified a few in the real world. In this paper, the researchers were trying to learn what affects a planet's lithosphere, or outermost layer. On Earth, the lithosphere has two main parts. The inner layer is hot and a bit squishy, and the outer layer is cool, hard, and brittle. This brittle layer is the part that can build up features like mountains, and how thick it is has a big effect on what a planet is like. If a planet has a thicker, brittle layer, it might be able to support plate tectonics like Earth. That's the process where big pieces of the lithosphere move around the planet, forming mountains and getting recycled. But tectonic plates are also important for releasing a planet's internal heat to space, as well as how gases leak out and help sustain an atmosphere. So they play a role in how habitable a planet is. So it's no surprise that scientists want to know more about lithospheres on other worlds. Unfortunately, our telescopes are not good enough to see surface features on planets beyond our solar system, or what we call exoplanets. Instead, astronomers have to find ways of inferring what an exoplanet looks like based on things they can measure, like the planet's mass, its size, age, and distance from its star. So to learn more about exoplanet lithospheres, this team built a computer model based on equations scientists had previously figured out for how different rocks behave on Earth. Then they ran simulations with thousands of exoplanets, all of which had a composition similar to our planets. In the end, the models showed that the exoplanets' masses, surface temperatures, and the ages of their lithospheres all had an influence on the thickness of that brittle layer. So planets that are small, old, or chilly, like because they're far from their stars, were more likely to have thick lithospheres. They also found that planets with a thin, brittle layer, which they called eggshell planets, were likely to have a few things in common. They found that they're likely to be more massive than Earth and have enough surface heat to keep that brittle layer thin. And that heat could come from a bunch of different places. Like the planets could be geologically young, they could have a lot more radioactive materials for extra long-term heating, or both of those things. They could also be closer to their stars and or have a thick atmosphere that could trap a lot of heat. In our solar system, Venus has some of those things relative to Earth. And in fact, Venus's flat lowlands might be what an eggshell planet's crust looks like, meaning that we might have at least a partial example of an eggshell planet quite nearby. But this team may have also found some proper eggshell worlds. They identified three exoplanets scientists have already observed that might have brittle layers less than 5 kilometers thick, and with how many exoplanets there are, more will be out there. In any case, having a way to understand what an exoplanet's lithosphere is like is a major way to understand what things might be like on that world. If it could potentially be habitable, with plate tectonics like Earth, or if it's more like Venus. Figuring out if a world light years away could support life is a big challenge, so the more tools we have, the more we will understand. Closer to home, our next story comes from a paper published last week in Communications, Earth, and Environment, and it focuses on Earth's long-term relationship. Not with the moon, but with the Quasimoon, Kamo'oaleva. This tiny space potato was discovered in 2016 by the Pan-STAR survey in Hawaii. It's called a Quasimoon because it doesn't really orbit the Earth like an actual moon does, but it's almost always pretty close to us while we go around the sun. Also, its orbit is a bit askew, so its position changes from being ahead of the Earth in its orbit to being behind it and back again. Now, Earth has had other quasi-satellites before, but they tend to come and go. Meanwhile, this Quasimoon seems to have been in our vicinity for the past century, and calculations suggest it'll stick around even longer, and that makes it a prime target to learn about quasi-satellites in general. In this new study, one team observed the Quasimoon with two ground-based telescopes, looking at different wavelengths of light reflected off its surface. By doing this, they confirmed that the space potato is spinning pretty fast, making one full rotation every 28 minutes. They also confirmed that it's mostly made of silicate minerals. Except, the exact composition of those minerals wasn't in line with other asteroids in this part of the solar system. So, Where did Kamo'oa lava come from? One hypothesis is that it came from some larger rock that got ripped apart by the gravity from the Earth-Moon system. Although, that kind of pushes the question back, because, like, then where did that rock come from? But another idea is that this quasi-satellite was chipped off of the moon itself, which is also made of silicate minerals. To test this lunar origin idea, the team compared Kamo'oa lava's apparent composition to those of different moon rocks. And although it was not a perfect match, there were a lot of similarities, to the point where some of the researchers think this is the most likely explanation based on what we now know. That said, if the space potato did break off the moon, figuring out where and how is gonna be a challenge. To know more, scientists will need to get samples from the moon as part of some upcoming mission, and they'll also need to learn more about Kamo'oa lava itself. But luckily, in the meantime, this quasi-moon will continue to be our quasi-close companion for a few more centuries, and that's plenty of time to unlock its secrets. And something that unlocked other space secrets for years was the legendary Arecibo Observatory, which we have immortalized as this month's pin to commemorate all its discoveries. So if you'd like to take a tiny version of this observatory home with you, you should visit dftba.com/scishow. But you need to act fast, because it is only available in November, because in December, we will have a whole new pin for you.